Hello there guys, this is Devin Paul, and today I'm your host of the Panteers Daily, and we're going to be talking about learning to love the development process. The development process meaning your growth in any area of your life or your actual putting in of the work to develop. Whenever you're learning to play handpans or you're learning to practice or really do anything new, there is a development process. And that development process includes a lot of time of practicing, of trying to learn, trying to memorize, and apply what you're learning, right? So the hardest part about loving the development process is actually getting over this mentality of this is a chore, this is something difficult, I'm doing this for X reason. And most of the time, those reasons aren't true to ourselves. And we're using our language and our ability to kind of like rationalize things to make ourselves feel a little bit worse about actually doing these things. So like, whenever you're sitting down to practice, you could be thinking to yourself, oh man, I could be practicing. Or for the younger generation, I could be playing video games. Yeah, you could be playing video games. Or you could be practicing, but which one is going to benefit you in the long run, you know? Unless, of course, you're going to become a professional gamer. For some of the older folks, I could be reading, or I could be practicing. Reading will definitely benefit you, but music and performing and practicing will develop you as a musician, will elevate your perspective. And I'm not saying that reading doesn't elevate your perspective, but music is a different type of perspective. Reading, you're getting other people's perspectives and other people's ideas. Music, you're getting your own and creating your own so that people can listen to them, right? And another thing that we use language to rationalize is not putting in that time, is justifying ourselves or justifying it to ourselves as to why we didn't put in that time. One of my old instructors, Drew Tucker, always used to tell us, I was in high school in the front ensemble with marching band, and he said, English is one of the most destructive, powerful tools that we use against ourselves, meaning we rationalize everything. So here's yes, here's no, but then there shouldn't be any middle ground, so we rationalize everything in between. Whenever we go and we perform and we don't do the best, we're like, oh yeah, you know, we put in the best that we could have done. When realistically, you probably didn't. You're using the English language or whatever language it is that you might be speaking to make it easier on yourself to let yourself down. So don't do that. Don't let yourself down, and don't make it okay to let yourself down whenever you have these expectations and these goals. But learn to love the development process, learn to love putting in the practice time, create those habits where you're setting aside time every day to practice, whether it be a new language or an instrument, whatever it might be that you're wanting to accomplish, and without a doubt, you'll be able to succeed in whatever it is that you're trying to do. Anyways guys, that is it for this episode of the Panteers Daily. I really appreciate you guys watching, and I can't wait to talk to you next time. Just make sure you put any comments or questions down below in the comment section, or email them to me at ask@thepanteers.com, and I can't wait to talk to you next time. Take care.